Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about the anatomy of right atrium. Heart consists of four chambers, right and left atria and right and left ventricles. So coming to the right atrium, you are familiar with this two diagrams, anterior view of the heart and this is the posterior view of the heart. Right atrium, this is the right atrium. Right atrium contributes in the formation of the sternocostal surface in the base of the heart and even the upper border of the heart. It forms whole of the right border of the heart. This right border of the heart coincides with the sulcus terminalis, a groove present on the outer surface of the heart. This sulcus terminalis corresponds to the crista terminalis present within the right atrium. Right atrium receives the blood from superior vena cava at its upper end and the inferior vena cava at its lower end. Right atrium is elongated chamber of the heart. From its anterosuperior part, it shows the ear-like appendage which passes towards the left side called as right auricle. This right auricle, it overlaps the root of ascending aorta and the infundibulum of the right ventricle. It shows the notch margins. From the right atrium, blood enters into the right ventricle through the right atrioventricular orifice, which will be present within the cavity at this place. It is guarded by the three cusps, anterior cusp, posterior cusp, and septal cusp. To see the interior of the right atrium, we will cut open the anterior wall of the right atrium and reflect it laterally. So we have reflected the flap of the right atrium laterally. So here this green color now is the crista terminalis, which corresponds to the sulcus terminalis present on the outer aspect of the right atrium. This interior of the right atrium is divided in the three parts: posterior smooth part, which is also called as sinus venarum, as it is developed from absorption of the right horn of the sinus venosus; anterior rough part, called as atrium proper, and it is developed from the right half of the primitive atrial chamber of the heart tube. Both these parts, posterior smooth part and the anterior rough part, are separated from each other by this crista terminalis septal wall. So septal wall shows the features of the interatrial septum from the right side. So first we will see about the posterior smooth part. So posterior smooth part is this area which lies behind the crista terminalis. This posterior smooth part, it receives the opening of three veins: superior vena cava, inferior vena cava and coronary sinus. Superior vena cava drains the venous blood from the upper part of the body. Inferior vena cava drains the blood from the lower part of the body. Coronary sinus drains the blood from the heart. 60% of the venous blood of the heart is drained by the coronary sinus. First about the superior vena cava. At the upper end of this right atrium, we can see the opening of the superior vena cava. Just below the opening of superior vena cava, there is an elevation called as intervenous tubercle of Lawyer. Intervenous tubercle of Lawyer. It is prominent in quadrupeds, but very scarcely visible in the human being, probably directs the blood from the superior vena cava to the right ventricle. Coming to the opening of the inferior vena cava. Suppose if you see the inferior vena cava, anterior view of the inferior vena cava, here we'll have two walls. This is anterior wall and here will be the posterior wall. So this inferior vena cava opens in the lower part of the right atrium and it is guarded by a semilunar wall called as the Eustachian wall, which is attached to the anterior wall of the opening of inferior vena cava. So this wall is the Eustachian wall. It is semilunar wall. By its convex margin, it is attached to the anterior wall of inferior vena cava and its concave margin is free in the right atrium. It has two ends. Left end is called left horn and the right end is called right horn. Left horn of this Eustachian wall is continuous with the limbus fossa ovalis. Limbus fossa ovalis. While the right end or right horn of this Eustachian wall is continuous with the lower end of the crista terminalis. And this wall in the fetal life directs the blood from the inferior vena cava into the left atrium through the foramen ovale. So that is about the opening of the inferior vena cava. Coming to the opening of coronary sinus, you get the opening of coronary sinus, which is situated between the opening of the inferior vena cava and the right atrioventricular orifice. Here the right atrioventricular orifice is guarded by the three cusp and this is the septal cusp. We are drawing only one cusp. This is the septal cusp of the tricuspid orifice. This is the opening of coronary sinus present between the opening of inferior vena cava and right atrioventricular orifice. It is guarded by half moon shape, that is semilunar wall at its lower margin. This is called as Thebesian wall. Thebesian wall. This is the coronary sinus, opening of coronary sinus, which is guarded by Thebesian wall. Here is the inferior vena cava guarded by the Eustachian wall. Thebesian wall, this Eustachian wall and the crista terminalis, these three are derived developmentally from right venous valve. In addition to these three openings, you get minute openings, small openings are present on the posterior surface of right atrium. These openings are called as the foramina venarum minimarum, through which the small veins of the heart called as veni cordis minimi. Cordis means heart, minimi small, small veins of the heart, veni cordis minimi, which are just like pits present in all the four chambers of the heart. They open on the surface through this foramina venarum minimarum. These veins are numerous in the right chambers of the heart than the left chambers, ensuring good blood supply to the right chambers of the heart. And because of that, myocardial infarctions are common on the left chambers of the heart. So that is about the posterior smooth part. Now coming to the anterior rough part. Anterior rough part lies in front of this crista terminalis. You know, the crista terminalis is a muscular elevation which coincides with the sulcus terminalis. It starts from superior vena cava and ends at the right horn of the Eustachian wall. The uppermost end near the superior vena cava contains SA node. SA node, the pacemaker of the heart. It lies in the uppermost part of the crista terminalis near the superior vena cava. From the crista terminalis, you get numerous muscular ridges extend forwards towards the right atrioventricular orifice, giving the appearance of tooth of a comb. So these ridges, muscular ridges, are called as the musculi pectinati. Pectin means comb like structure, musculi pectinati, and because of that the anterior rough part is also called as the pectinate part. In addition to that, you can get 3 to 4 openings of anterior cardiac veins which directly open in the right atrium. Near the lower part, sometimes you get the opening of right marginal vein. If it won't open in the small cardiac vein, it directly opens in the right atrium. This musculi pectinati, they make sponge-like structure or network within this right auricle, which slows down the blood flow through the right auricle, and it favors the formation of the thrombi. This thrombi, if dislodged during atrial fibrillation, may cause the pulmonary embolism. So that is about the anterior rough part. Now coming to the septal wall. Septal wall shows the saucer-shaped depression or oval depression called as fossa ovalis. So this depression is called as fossa ovalis. Floor of this fossa ovalis is developed from septum primum. This fossa ovalis is guarded by sickle-shaped fold, which is prominent above anteriorly and posteriorly but deficient inferiorly, which is called as limbus fossa ovalis or annulus ovalis, and this indicates the lower margin of septum secundum. Sometimes in 25% cases, you may get a volvular opening between the upper part of this fossa ovalis and the limbus fossa ovalis, which is directed upwards and towards the left side. This is called as propetency of foramen ovale. Propetency of foramen ovale, which indicates that physiologically foramen ovale is closed, but anatomically it remains open. In addition to that, here above this opening of coronary sinus, you get the subendocardial ridge called as tendon of Todaro. So it is called as tendon of Todaro. It is subendocardial ridge. It is the part of the fibrous skeleton of the heart. It extends towards the opening of inferior vena cava. It bounds the triangular area. Here it bounds the triangular area called as triangle of Koch. Is called as the triangle of Koch, which lodges AV node. This triangle of Koch lodges AV node. So if you see the boundaries of this triangle of Koch, it is bounded in front by the septal cusp of the tricuspid orifice. Posteriorly, it is bounded by tendon of Todaro, and inferiorly it is bounded by opening of the coronary sinus. In the upper part, there is an elevation present in this region called as torus aorticus, and this torus aorticus is produced by the ascending aorta. To be specific, it is produced by posterior right non-coronary sinus of the ascending aorta. Okay, so this is torus aorticus. So that is about the interior of the right atrium. So for our convenience, we divide the interior of right atrium in the three parts: posterior smooth part called sinus venarum, anterior rough part called as the pectinate part or the atrium proper, and the septal wall. And these are the features of the interior of right atrium. Same features we will see in the specimen of the heart. Thank you. This is the heart. Heart consists of two atria and two ventricles, right atrium, left atrium. right ventricle and left ventricle. Now in this video we will see the interior of this right atrium. This is right atrium and the ear-like appendage of the right atrium, which extends towards the left side covering the root of the ascending aorta and the infundibulum of right ventricle, is called as the auricle, right auricle. This right atrium, it is an elongated chamber. It receives from above, it receives, this is superior vena cava, and from below it receives inferior vena cava. It contributes in the formation of the sternocostal surface, base of the heart, upper border of the heart and complete right border of the heart. Now coming to the interior of the right atrium, we are cutting the right atrium and reflecting it to see the interior. Now interior of the right atrium we will discuss in the three parts: posterior smooth part, anterior rough part and the septal wall. So first about the posterior smooth part. This is the posterior smooth part. This posterior smooth part and anterior rough part are separated from each other by elevated ridge here. This is called as the crista terminalis. So behind the crista terminalis is the smooth posterior smooth part. In front of the crista terminalis you get the anterior rough part. Now coming to the posterior smooth part. Posterior smooth part is also called as the sinus venarum. It is developmentally derived from the absorption of the right horn of the sinus venosus. Now features, it shows the opening of superior vena cava in the upper part. Just below the opening of superior vena cava, there is an elevation called as intervenous tubercle of Lawyer on the posterior wall of the right atrium. It is scarcely visible in human being but is prominently seen in the quadrupeds, and probably it directs the blood flow from superior vena cava to the right ventricle. In the lower part of the right atrium, you can see this is actually cut open. This is the opening of the inferior vena cava, which is guarded by semilunar wall. You can see this wall. So this wall is the semilunar wall. This is called as the Eustachian wall. It has a convex margin which is attached to the anterior wall of inferior vena cava. It has the concave free margin which is projected into the right atrium. It has two ends. This is the left end which is called as the left horn, which is continuous with limbus fossa ovalis. Left horn of the Eustachian wall is continuous with limbus fossa ovalis, and the right horn, that is right end, is continuous with lower end of this crista terminalis. And this Eustachian wall in fetal life directs the blood from inferior vena cava to the left atrium through the foramen ovale. So that is about inferior, opening of the inferior vena cava. In the posterior wall you can see numerous small openings in the wall of this right atrium. This called foramina venarum minimarum. In all the four chambers of the heart you get small pits. These pits are nothing but the small veins of the heart called as the veni cordis minimi, which open here in all the four chambers. You can see a small opening here that is called foramina venarum minimarum. So these openings are present in all the four chambers of the heart, but more on the right side, ensuring the good blood supply to the right chambers of the heart, and that's why myocardial infarctions are more common on the left chambers of the heart. In addition to the superior inferior vena cava, you can see the opening of coronary sinus. Here you can see the opening of coronary sinus, and this opening of coronary sinus is guarded by the wall here. This wall is again semilunar wall and called as the Thebassian wall. This Thebassian wall plus Eustachian wall and the crista terminalis all are derived from the right venous wall. Now coming to the anterior rough part, the part which lies in front of the crista terminalis. It is derived from the right half of the primitive atrial chamber of the heart tube, and it is a rough, many muscular ridges which extend from the crista terminalis run parallel to each other, giving the appearance of the tooth of comb. So the word musculi pectinati. Pectin means comb. These are called musculi pectinati, which arise from crista terminalis. They run downwards and forwards towards this opening. This opening is the right atrioventricular opening, and this musculopectinity make the meshwork or sponge like network in this right auricle, which slows down the blood flow and favors the thrombosis. In atrial fibrillation, this thrombosis may get dislodged, leading to the pulmonary embolism. So that is about anterior rough part. Coming to the features of the septal wall. Now this is the septal wall. It shows the saucer shaped depression. This is saucer shaped depression called as fossa ovalis, which is derived from septum primum. This is fossa ovalis derived from septum primum. It shows the prominent borders above, in front and behind, and this prominent margin is called as the limbus fossa ovalis or annulus ovalis, which indicates the lower free margin of septum secundum. In between fossa ovalis and this limbus fossa ovalis, in 25% cases you may get the foramen present, and this is called as the propetency of foramen oval, which communicate the right atrium to the left atrium. So though physiologically the foramen ovale is closed, it may remain open anatomically in 25% of the cases. In addition to that, you can see here the tendon of Todaro. Here the subendocardial ridge, it is the part of fibroskeleton of the heart. Below this tendon of Todaro, you get a triangular area which is bounded by, this is septal cusp. This is atrioventricular or right atrioventricular orifice. This is septal cusp. So at the base of the septal cusp of right atrioventricular orifice, below the tendon of Todaro and above the opening of coronary sinus, you get a triangular area called as triangle of Koch. This triangle of Koch contains the AV node, while uppermost part of the crista terminalis, where it starts from the opening of superior vena cava, it contains SA node, the pacemaker of the heart. So here you can see the atrioventricular orifice. The part of the right atrium near the atrioventricular orifice is called as the vestibule. Here you can see the elevation in the upper part of the right atrium, which is called torus aorticus, which is produced by the ascending aorta. So that is about the interior of right atrium. So interior of right atrium, we divide it by the crista terminalis in the posterior smooth part, anterior rough part. In addition to that, this is the septal wall. And these all are the features in the interior of the right atrium.